The e-collar must not be too big because the dog is very angry.
Okay, okay.
Dogs are angry, the big e-collar cannot eat and drink. This one is the correct size. Now hold the eye, careful the eye, no. The bed is open up and don't push in like that, open up there. That is the safest because the eye injured then rupture. This is the way to do, no? Must open up. You don't push in like that, push in like that. Because then on top, no, this side, the hole is on top. The hole is on top, no, the hole. Then it's in out. Then the method is in out. Which is the one you do? The closest one? The smallest one? Which one? This is the smallest one, right?
The smallest one.
Yep.
Okay, because otherwise too loose. This one you can eat and drink. So normally, if he has this painkiller, he doesn't rub his eyes. Without the painkiller, he... No more already. This one has got subcutaneous level injection, remember I was telling you? This one had... During the separate video, there will be a separate video. And the surgery. Eyelid flap plus tarsorrhaphy.
Okay. Good
this
point.
This dog sometimes he bark and bark for what reason? Sometimes he bark for no reason.
Attention.
Oh.
Then sometimes when he shit really he
want to clean up to clean up the place.
Want to shit also he will bark.
No, the clean up I think. He went to clean up.
小便也是他会叫。
对。
Okay, so painkiller 40 on, 40 off, antibiotics and eye drops, eye ointment. Then go home, then check in 14 days, should be a white scar. Now you can see very terrible, it looks terrible. It's a just stitch removal 10 days after tarsorrhaphy and third eyelid flap. Okay, go home already.